things are looking pretty good for Elon Musk and SpaceX, the company founded back in 2002 with the intent of reinvigorating space exploration. In the last 6 months alone, SpaceX has conducted 2 successful untethered tests with the SpaceX Starship Hopper, finished work on the first orbital-class Starship test vehicle, and deployed the first batch of its Starlink broadband internet satellites to space. SpaceX Starship, currently in parallel development at SpaceX's South Texas and Florida facilities, is intended to be an all-purpose successor to and replacement for both Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, with a higher payload capacity and the ability to reach the Moon and eventually Mars. And the 70th International Astronautical Congress, which took place last week in Washington, D.C., SpaceX President and Chief Operations Officer Gwynne Shotwell outlined plans for its 2 developments, giving her forecast for when the company will fly people on its next-generation rocket and begin offering internet from its satellite network. SpaceX has already received more than $1.3 billion this year for its 2 major ongoing projects. One is building the SpaceX Starship. The other ambitious project is Starlink, a network of up to 30,000 satellites that will provide global internet coverage. SpaceX is building multiple Starship rockets at once, as founder Elon Musk has the company on an ambitious timeline to begin launching Starship regularly and prove that it can be reused easily, like an aircraft. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX's plans to land Starship on the Moon within 3 years, with people soon after. Let's get into details. Shotwell, speaking at Barron Fund's annual investment conference at the Metropolitan Opera House on Friday, the 25th of October, gave an update on SpaceX's goals for Starship. "Aspirationally, we want to get Starship to orbit within a year," Shotwell said. "We definitely want to land it on the Moon before 2022. We want to stage cargo there to make sure that there are resources for the folks that ultimately land on the Moon by 2024 if things go well." So that's the aspirational time frame. So far, the company has built and tested a so-called Starhopper demonstration vehicle, which consisted of just the base of the vehicle and one of the Raptor engines it will use for its new SpaceX Starship launch system and Super Heavy booster. After completing successful low-altitude flights with that vehicle, SpaceX moved on to assembling its Mark 1 and Mark 2 Starship test vehicles, which represent the full scale of the ultimate orbital spacecraft, and which are being built by teams in Boca Chica, Texas, and Cape Canaveral Space Launch Complex 40 in Florida, respectively. The Mark 1 was unveiled at a press conference back in September, during the company's 11th anniversary, where Musk presented the latest updates on the SpaceX Starship's design and the company's proposed timeline. However, much like Musk in his presentation last month, Shotwell hedged her estimate, saying that, "Every time I make a prediction about my schedule, I turn myself into a liar." Currently, SpaceX is focused on the final tests of the Crew Dragon capsule, the next steps of which are to fly 2 astronauts to the International Space Station. "It's a critical program for us, as it's our first step to flying astronauts," Shotwell said. She said SpaceX wants to fly Crew Dragon frequently so the company can learn as much as it can about flying people safely. While SpaceX has dozens of successful rocket launches under its belt, it's yet to fly astronauts. The first Crew Dragon flights will go to the International Space Station, much like the uncrewed test mission SpaceX performed with the capsule in March, and will be an important step towards its grander ambitions. "Then we'll put people on Starship and send them to farther places," Shotwell said. That's an ambitious timeline, and as Shotwell herself repeatedly stated, these are aspirational timelines. In the space industry, as well as in tech, it's not uncommon for leadership to set aggressive schedules in order to drive the teams working on projects to work at the limits of what's actually possible. If this is starting to sound familiar, that's probably because it's entirely like Elon Musk himself to be optimistic with timelines. And while SpaceX has not always met the deadlines Musk has set in the past, they've managed to deliver on all their promises. From the development of reusable first-stage rockets and the creation of the Falcon Heavy, to the recovery of payload fairings and the deployment of broadband satellites. And as Shotwell touched on during her onstage interview at the 2019 IAC, Musk's ambitious nature is an essential part of their success. Elon puts out these incredibly audacious goals and people say, "You're not going to do it. You'll never get to orbit. You'll never get a real rocket to orbit. You'll never get Heavy to orbit. You'll never get Dragon to the station. You'll never get Dragon back. You'll never land a rocket." So frankly, I love when people say we can't do it because it motivates my fantastic 6,500 employees to go do that thing. Speaking of ambitious, Musk has already stated that he hopes to conduct high-altitude test flights using the Mark 1 and Mark 2 sometime next year. After then, SpaceX will be constructing additional prototypes to launch to low Earth orbit and eventually crewed test flights. Once complete, SpaceX Starship will be an immense rocket, as SpaceX designed the rocket to carry as many as 100 people. But more importantly, it will be fully reusable. Shotwell said that SpaceX is applying lessons learned from landing rockets to ensure the reusability. If you're going to take people to other planets, you can't wait for a new aerospace industry to develop on the planet before you can figure out how to land a rocket. You have to figure out how to land, refuel, and come back, Shotwell said. SpaceX is already successful at booster recovery, having recovered 44 boosters from its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets. But while the booster recoveries have been a step forward in rocketry, it only represents the bottom portion of the rocket. However, with the SpaceX Starship, it wants to recover both the Super Heavy booster and the upper part of the rocket. "So we're not going to waste anything. All we'll spend money on is fuel," Shotwell said. SpaceX Starship will feature in the company's plans in more ways than just exploration. Shotwell revealed that SpaceX plans to use the new rocket to deploy its Starlink network even more quickly than it is already. SpaceX launched the first 60 Starlink satellites in May, packing them into the top of a Falcon 9 rocket. And just before the launch, Musk told reporters that SpaceX has sufficient capital to get its Starlink satellite network to an operational level. "In the next few weeks, we're going to launch another 60, and then get to a cadence of launching 60 every other week to fill out the constellation," Shotwell said, adding that 360 to 400 satellites are needed for constant connectivity, where the satellites can end up through the ground talking to each other. "Once we get to 1,200 satellites, we'll have coverage of the whole globe." Once SpaceX is flying Starship regularly, she said the rocket will be able to launch nearly 7 times as many Starlink satellites at once. Shotwell said that the SpaceX Starship can take 400 satellites at a time, speeding up the timeline for the project's completion. SpaceX Starlink is the preferred project of investors, generating more than $30 billion annually, and the source of funding for Musk's vision of populating Mars. Completing SpaceX Starlink will cost significantly less than the estimate of $60 billion issued by Morgan Stanley last week, Shotwell reassured investors. "Unlike traditional satellites, SpaceX Starlinks will have limited lifespans of about 5 years," Shotwell explained. "SpaceX will refresh the technology of the Starlink network by rapidly replacing the satellites, which are designed to intentionally burn up in the Earth's atmosphere. These satellites will be limited in their life because the longer you want the satellites to live on orbit, the more money you have to put into it," Shotwell said. "We will be continually launching these satellites to refresh the technology, to address any issues with the satellites, to put up ones that are working better in its place." SpaceX has already been contracted by Intuitive Machines and iSpace, two commercial aerospace companies that have signed with NASA to deliver payloads to the moon. These contracts are part of the agency's Lunar Cargo Transportation and Landing by Soft Touchdown Catalyst program, which is seeking partners to provide logistical support in advance of the Artemis missions, which are scheduled to send astronauts there by 2024. These agreements specify that SpaceX will be providing launch services using its fleet of Falcon 9 rockets. However, SpaceX made it known some time ago that the Starship and Super Heavy launch system will be replacing their Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets as the company's workhorse. "Sending cargo and passengers to the moon will always be a major step towards fulfilling Musk's ultimate vision, which is establishing a human settlement on Mars. If all goes according to plan and in a timely manner, Musk hopes to have the settlement up and running by 2028. Yet another optimistic and ambitious goal. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.